Hello friends, in the previous video you learned about square numbers and some of their interesting patterns. In this video we will learn more about square and its patterns. Observe the following numbers carefully. Do you notice any pattern here? You are absolutely right. It shows the pattern of the square of numbers starting with 3. Let us express these numbers as a sum of 2 consecutive numbers. We can express the square of 3 as the sum of numbers 5 and 4. We can write the square of 5 as the sum of numbers 12 and 13. And the square of 7 as the sum of numbers 24 and 25. Can we also express the squares of 4 and 6 as the sum of 2 consecutive positive integers? Did you notice anything special in this activity? You are absolutely right. Here we observe that we cannot express the square of numbers 4 and 6 in this way. That is, we can express the square of any odd number as the sum of 2 consecutive positive integers. But we cannot express the square of any even number as the sum of 2 consecutive positive integers. If you pay attention, you will notice that the first consecutive number is obtained by subtracting 1 from the square number and dividing by 2. The second number is obtained by adding 1 to the square number and then dividing the sum by 2. Come on, let's understand more about square numbers and their patterns. Look at the product of these numbers. Can you find the product of these numbers without multiplying the 2 numbers? We can write the product of 2 consecutive even or odd natural numbers in this way. Thus, we can express the product of 12 and 14 and 13 and 15 in this way. Therefore, we can find the product of 2 consecutive even or odd natural numbers by subtracting 1 from the square of the number that lies between them. We will now understand the method for finding the square of a number. As numbers get bigger, it becomes more difficult to find their square using the product method, and at the same time, it takes more time. For instance, to find the square of 51, we will have to multiply 51 by 51. Let us consider a new method to find the square of a number. We can write the square of 51 as the square of 50 plus 1 and solve it in this way. With the help of this method, we can easily find the square of any two-digit number. Did you know that? We can find the square of all numbers ending in 5 using a simpler method. For instance, consider the square of numbers 65 and 85. Here we have added 1 to the digit in the tens place and multiplied the sum obtained by the digit in the tens place. Next, we have multiplied the number obtained by 100 and added 25 to it. See, wasn't that interesting? Let us now understand about the Pythagorean triplet method. In the previous class, we learned about the Pythagoras property, which states, in a right-angled triangle, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares on its legs. Did you know that the group of 3 numbers that can represent the sides of a right-angled triangle are called Pythagorean triplet numbers? Which means, in a Pythagorean triplet, the sum of squares of 2 numbers is equal to the square of the 3rd number. For example, the numbers 3, 4 and 5 are Pythagorean triplet. Here, we observe that for any natural number n greater than 1, we have 2n, n square minus 1 and n square plus 1 forms a Pythagorean triplet. Like for number 3, the numbers 6, 8 and 10 will be a Pythagorean triplet. In today's video, we learned about the pattern of square numbers, the method of finding the square of a number, and the Pythagorean triplet. In the next video, we will see some examples related to them. Thank you.